is Douglas Moore, and I have been held captive in Cuba since January 2003. The man primarily responsible for this is former Cuban Minister of Justice Alberto Sotolongo, who was himself secretly arrested in February 2007 on a charge of trafficking in people. In March 2007, I made William M. Hammaker of the United States Interest Section aware of Alberto Sotolongo's secret arrest, along with 23 other high-ranking Cuban government officials. In retribution, Cuba put me into complete isolation until well after they publicly announced Alberto Sotolongo's arrest in August 2010. Why the United States State Department remained silent about this, I do not know. Simply put, there is no justice in Cuba under the regime of Fidel and Raul Castro. The Marxist brothers are not funny. They are only money and power-hungry killers that will do anything to maintain control of Cuba, to keep the wealth earned by the Cuban people rolling into their secret bank accounts. Being a born Anglo-American, held captive in a country that is been brainwashed to despise me is not easy. I am singled out for abuse, and I cannot count all the times that I have been chained by my hands and legs and beaten mercilessly, then robbed of my few meager possessions by the Guardia Frontera here at Caminado del Este. The conditions here at Caminado del Este are subhuman, and the food is unfit for human consumption. On February 3rd, 2012, I went on a hunger strike that lasted for over a week. The purpose of that hunger strike was in protest for my not being allowed a religious minister visit from a person of my choosing, rather than from a minister who was a Cuban of Fidel and Raul's choosing and ultimately works for them. In response to my hunger strike, the Guardia Frontera here at Caminado del Este, who worship Fidel and Raul as living gods, threatened to arrest my girlfriend, who is a mother of two, who are dependent on her. This is the famous Cuban heart that Fidel and Raul Castro have. What courage they have to arrest a single mother of two. How long will it be until brainwashing DC get serious about changing Cuba, rather than spending lots of our money pretending to be serious about changing Cuba? Logic dictates that we should ask the simple question why Washington, D.C. busies itself cleaning up the garbage on the other side of the planet. Bin Laden, Gaddafi, etc., etc., etc. While here, on its own front porch, they have done nothing for 50 years about Fidel and Raul Castro, except for talk about doing something about Fidel and Raul Castro. When are they going to take the garbage out here on their own front porch? That in itself opens the door to another good question. Is there a secret relationship between Fidel and Raul Castro and Washington, D.C. that we do not know about? Or perhaps even a secret friendship between Fidel and Raul Castro that brain Washington and D.C. and Fidel and Raul run on calling each other enemies all the time in order to distract us from what's really going on? A secret relationship and friendship? In closing, I would like to say hello to my mother and my father and all the rest of my family and friends that I have not been permitted to see for over 10 years. Thanks, finally, to Dana Bergen Garcia Garcia for allowing me to tell a little bit of my story. Goodbye.